الرحمن الرحيم. Today our lecture will be about the physiology of vision. Actually, this lecture will be divided into many parts. At the beginning, we will start with functional anatomy of the eye and external structure and its internal layers. Then we'll go to the process of refraction, discussing what is error of refractions and what's their treatment, explain the mechanism then of vision. Cones and rods and their role. At last, we'll discuss what the pathophysiology of lesions of the eye and its optic nerve. Starting, the eye only sees small proportion of the spectrum of electromagnetic waves that ranges from 350 to 750 nanometers. Starting with the accessory structure of the eye and externally. Eyelids, palpebrae, which is separated by the palpebral fissure, upper and lower eyelids, eyelashes, tarsal gland, and lacrimal apparatus. This is here. Actually, the upper and lower eyelids or palpebrae shade the eyes during sleep, protects the eye from excessive light and foreign objects, and spread lubricating secretions over the eyeballs. The eyelashes and the eyebrows help to protect the eyeballs from foreign object perspiration and direct rays of the sun. Coming to the lacrimal apparatus, the lacrimal glands are supplied by parasympathetic fibers of the facial nerve, seventh nerve. The lacrimal fluid contains salt, mucus, lysozymes, so that its function is to protect, cleanse, lubricate, and moisten the eyeball. Because dryness of the eyeball is too dangerous for the eye, meaning to ulceration, sometimes even to loss or impairment of vision. Tears from the form in the lacrimal glands, they wash across the surface of the eye and collect in the lacrimal lake, and they pass through the lacrimal punctum, superior and inferior, to the lacrimal canaliculi, lacrimal sac, and nasolacrimal duct. This is the lacrimal gland, so that the lacrimal fluid comes here and drained into superior and inferior lacrimal punctum, then to the lacrimal sac, then also to the lacrimal canaliculi, to the lacrimal sac, then to the nasolacrimal duct. Each gland produces about 1 mL of lacrimal fluid per day. Lacrimation is a protected mechanism, as the tears dilute and wash away the irritating and harming substances if they come to the eye. Watery eyes also occur when there is inflammation of the nasal mucosa, as we said, because the interconnection of the nasolacrimal duct. Only humans express emotions in happiness and sadness by crying, response to parasympathetic stimulation. Extrinsic eye muscles, six extrinsic eye muscles. Move each eye, superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus, medial rectus, superior oblique, and inferior oblique. They are supplied by the cranial nerves, third oculomotor, fourth trochlear, sixth abducens nerve. Actually, here to make it easy to remember, as LR6, which means that lateral rectus is supplied by the abducens sixth nerve, and SO4 superior oblique supplied by the fourth trochlear nerve, and the rest are supplied by the oculomotor nerve. Neural circuits in the brain stem and cerebellum coordinate and synchronize movement of the eyeball, like superior colliculus, which control them in response to certain things, such as to incoming light or whatever. So, coming to the inside of the eyeball, actually in a cross section of the eye we have three main layers: outer fibrous tonic or layer, which is composed of the opaque sclera and transparent cornea. This is anterior surface of the eye. This is from outer. Then the middle vascular tonic or layer, iris, the ciliary body, and the choroid. Then the inner inside, the nervous tonic which is the retina. These are simplified, so that this is the external, as we said, sclera here is opaque, while cornea at the anterior surface of the eye is transparent. This is the outer fibrous. The middle vascular, here posteriorly you have the choroid, then we have the ciliary body. This is an attachment with in which there is attachment to the lens, and in front it is the in front of the lens is the iris. Okay, so that there will be division divided into cavities, anterior cavity and posterior cavity. And to the inside, the inner most inner side is the neural part, which is the retina. Coming to the details of each one, the superficial layer of the eyeball and consists of the fibrostonic of the anterior cornea and the posterior sclera. Cornea is transparent to help focus the light onto the retina. Sclera is whitish and hardly covers the retina, the entire eyeball except at the cornea. It gives the shape of the eyeball, make it more rigid, protecting the inner part, and serves as site of attachment of the extraocular muscles. At the junction of sclera and cornea, an opening called canal of Schlemm or scleral venous sinus, at which the fluid called aqueous humor drains into this sinus. Middle vascular tonic or uvea is the middle layer of the eyeball, composed of three parts: the choroid posteriorly, ciliary body, and the iris. The highly vascularized choroid, which is the posterior portion of the vascular tonic, lines most of the internal surface of the sclera. Numerous blood vessels provide nutrients to the posterior surface of the retina. Choroid also contains melanocyte that produce the pigment melanin, which causes this layer to appear dark brown in color. Melanin in the choroid absorbs stray light rays, which prevents reflection and scattering of the light within the eyeball. يعني يمنع تشتت الضوء حتى to help to focus it on the retina exactly. Albinos lack melanin at all parts of the body, including the eye, so often need to wear sunglasses. Albinos يعني المصابين بالبهاق يعني those they have a special يعني color. They wear sunglasses even indoors because lack of melanin, so it's affect their process of vision. The ciliary body, like the choroid, ciliary body appears dark brown in color because also melanin producing melanocytes, in addition, consists of ciliary process and ciliary muscles. The ciliary processes contain blood capillaries that secrete the aqueous humor. Extending from the ciliary process are the zonular fibers. They are the suspensory ligament that attach to the lens. So that the ciliary body is composed of ciliary process and the ciliary muscles. قلنا أنه ciliary muscle مسؤول عن secretion of the aqueous humor, which is drains at the canal of Schlemm. قلنا the junction of the sclera, the junction of the with the cornea with the sclera. Okay. Ciliary muscles, the circular band of a smooth muscle. Contraction or relaxation changes the tightness of the zonular fibers so that to alter the shape of links, so that adapted for near or far vision, and we help the process help in the process of accommodation, so that to focus the light rays exactly on the retina, so that to for a proper vision process. The iris consists of the melanocyte and the circular and radial smooth muscle fibers. The amount of melanin in the iris determines the eye color. A black, high concentration of melanin, a green, moderate, while if a blue colored eye, very low melanin concentration. Principal function of the iris is to regulate the amount of light entering the eyeball through the pupil, so that hole in the center of the iris. The pupil appear black to melanin pigment, while red on lightening due to the vascularity. When there is a bright light stimulates the eye or coming to the eye, Here the parasympathetic fibers of the oculomotor nerve will stimulate the circular muscles, sphincter, pupillae, so that lead to contract the iris, which means pupillary constriction or meiosis. This is when bright light. While in dim light, the sympathetic neuron here will prevail, so that will stimulate the radial muscles, the dilator pupillae, when they contract, so that increasing the size of the pupil, which is called midriasis or pupillary dilatation. And this we see, so that this is the circular muscles supplied by parasympathetic nerve. When there is strong light, there will be stimulation, parasympathetic stimulation, so that it will lead to pupillary constriction or meiosis. While if there is dim light, on the contrary, there will be stimulation of the radial muscles. These are supplied by sympathetic stimulation, so that when these muscles contract, it will pull, so that will cause widening of the opening of the eyeball, lead to pupillary dilatation, or what is called midriasis.